Hi, my name is Helena Walker, and today I'd like to teach you about a creature I've found swimming in waters within and around the island called Coelacanth nutricia. Also, Ned butchered the pronunciation in the first video, so that's why I'm here to fix his mistake. Coelacanths are actually still alive in the 21st century, making them a peculiar creature on the island when compared to the many other types of fish, prehistoric mammals, and dinosaurs. Coelacanth generally do not do all that much. They primarily glide through bodies of water, eating small plant matter, and presumably other sentient creatures that are smaller than themselves. Their primary threat appears to be survivors who hunt them for small amounts of fish meat, as well as for the potential for unique items. The methods survivors employ to hunt coelacanth typically involve beating them to death with a stone hatchet, spear, or even their fists. If they want to be fancy, they'll combine a fishing rod and lots of patience. When it comes to the rewards for fishing coelacanth, they tend to be at the lower end. Because coelacanth could be regarded as lower quality when compared to the Oncorhynchus or Megapiranha, fishing for them will typically result in less valuable items or resources. That said, it is not entirely pointless still. Theoretically speaking, if a survivor had something on par with a certain fishing device, perhaps one crafted in some other place than the island, they could actually tame coelacanth. But seeing as I know nothing beyond the island and have no theories whatsoever that it could possibly be orbiting around Earth, along with countless other arcs, in a massive plan to save humanity, I have no f***ing idea what a fish basket is. Assuming survivors did tame coelacanth, they would likely only be used as cute pets that otherwise cannot fight, provide any real protection, or do much of anything, really. I do wonder though, what a massive army of coelacanth could provide to the water-dwelling tribes of the island. Perhaps the painted sharks could utilize them as a way to scare other tribes into submission. Surely, having an army of coelacanth would at least be somewhat intimidating. I hope you learned a thing or two about coelacanths from this short video, and more importantly, let's hope you've internalized how to pronounce the thing for the rest of your life. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like and subscribe for more mispronunciations and fourth wall breaking content. Sincerely, Helena Walker.